Hello everyone, this is Curtis Pike and welcome back to another Adobe Premiere Pro tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how to put explosions into your footage. Yes, and we're going to be working with two different types of explosions. We're going to have explosions that are rendered with a background, like a black background in the back, and we're also going to have explosions that are rendered with an alpha channel. Now, the best way to do this is to find stock footage, so I've gone ahead and found some Civil War reenactment footage here, just for kicks. This is just as demonstration footage. This isn't to look realistic. And I've got two different types of explosions. The first type, I'll show you the more difficult type. The first one is this one here. I'll just close that to length. This one is an explosion, but it has a black background. That means there's no alpha channel. So this black shows up as black as opposed to transparent. If you have an alpha channel, it is transparent and you would not see it. So this is a more complicated explosion. So let's just leave that there. This is what it looks like. Bang. And the explosion comes in nice and slow. We'll go back to this in a second. The second effect I have is an explosion with an alpha channel. These are better. If you have access to it, to the right explosion with the channel, this is the best way to go, and I'll show you why. Here, I'll hit spacebar. Playing the footage. Boom. It slows down a little bit. It's rendering the effect, but whatever. That is pretty much good to go right out of the box. You can, of course, always make adjustments to it, but with an alpha channel, you get an explosion without any of the background. And then you could just go ahead and adjust the speed. If you want it to explode faster, for example, you would go to speed duration. And let's say it's way too slow, so you want a fast explosion, so we'll double the speed. Then bang, let's see what happens. Boom. Faster explosion. And of course it slows down a little bit when it's trying to render too much because my computer's slow, just like me. But that's all there is to it for alpha footage, guys. If you have explosive footage with alpha channel, use it. It's good. If you do not despair. We can go ahead and still make adjustments. Lots of stock video footage places, for example, have explosions like this, but they come rendered with a black background, so they're explosions on black. Now, traditionally, the way to get rid of this is to use what's called a Luma key. You drop the Luma key, I'll just go a little slower here. You go into the effects panel, go to Luma key, and you drop it on. Now look, we've got the explosion coming in, but if you look really, really closely at the edges, it's kind of washed out, and it just doesn't look all that convincing. So do not despair. With the recent blending modes inside Adobe Premiere Pro, we can go ahead and fix that. So if we click on the footage here, the explosive footage with the black background, go to the opacity here, and don't reduce the opacity. Like, it's very, very tempting to do, even though you can get a pretty good shot with that. You want to go ahead and go into your blending modes. Now, you could try all the different modes. You want to darken it. That doesn't work. You want to linear burn it. That doesn't work. But these modes, the lighten, the screen, and the color dodge, are modes that do work. Let's take a look at the three of them. When we click lighten, you notice the black background is gone away. The underlying mathematics of the equation, the underlying mathematics of the effect, that's what I meant to say, other E word, has rendered and taken out the black background. Lighten works. Let's try screen. Let's see what color we get with that. Okay, it's a little different. This is a little bit more, I guess you'd say, salient. It's quite out there. But you know what? Maybe that's the effect you're looking for. You can always go for the effect you want, not what I want. And the last one here you might want to try is color dodge. This is pretty heavy. This is like Apocalypse Now stuff, but take a look. Okay, it's really red and orange, so it is very, very dark. It might be too much for you, so you can always go ahead and either adjust the opacity or you could even do a color correction on it. But long story short, guys, if you have explosive footage where you have an explosion, you can either use with a alpha channel and you can just season it to your taste, or you can use with a black background and use the color modes here, or the blending modes, pardon me, and you'll be able to get the exact look you're going for. I hope this tutorial helped. I'll be back soon. Cheers.